Hi guys, my name is Nick Jennison for Guitar Interactive magazine, and on the test bench today we have the Acoustic preamp from the good folks over at Orange. Now I want to draw your attention to one particular little feature right over here, because we have our overhead cam. If you can see a little glow in between those little punched out holes in the chassis, that's because this is a valve acoustic preamp. Yes, that's right. It is Orange after all, and they do love them some valves. You really can't beat the sound of a nice valve pre, a nice valve compressor when it comes to recording acoustic guitar. And Orange are basically aiming to bring that into the live domain with this beautiful preamp. Now you heard me playing through channel 2 in the intro, or rather channel B as it's labeled, which is the uncolored channel in this one. So it doesn't have the valve compression or valve overdrive. We'll explore that in a moment, but I wanted to show you the wonderful EQ and reverb that this preamp is sporting first of all. Before we do anything, what I'm going to do is I'm going to return everything to flat, and we'll have a listen to the sound of this PRS SE acoustic guitar just as it stands through the uncolored Orange preamp. So we're going to turn the bass back to zero, treble is at zero, mid-range is at zero, and we'll just disengage the mute switch, and it's going to sound like this. And this is a completely uncolored version of the sound that we're putting into it. It's just being reproduced through these lovely transformers that are in this rather rugged preamp. Let's play with the EQ a little bit, and then we'll explore the settings on channel A, which has got the heat control. More on that in a moment. First thing I'd like to play with is the treble control. So we're gonna start by turning it up, and we'll see what it does. Now turning it down. Let's try the bass control. We'll do the same thing again. Here it is flat. Turning it up. And back down. So the two shelf controls for treble and bass are beautifully tuned for acoustic guitar and really flatter the way a guitar is supposed to sound without being overpowering or unmusical. Let's turn our attention to the mid control, which is a parametric mid with a frequency center and kind of a gain control. Now I used it to duck out a little bit of this slightly obnoxious honky frequency that I found here, but let's turn it up and see how that frequency sounds. It's kind of an aw vowel. What I'm going to do with that one is just duck a little bit out and we'll get this. And if we wanted to, we could combine that with a little bit of a treble and bass boost, just a tiny bit, and we should get this. Now, we're going to introduce some of the onboard reverb, which is an absolutely glorious sounding stereo reverb. You heard that in the intro. I'm going to creep that up pretty high, and we'll hear how it sounds. Thank you. Now, I've got to be honest with you, I think that is one of the best sounding acoustic reverbs that I've heard on a preamp, and I've looked at a few of them, let me tell you. It's a really great sounding reverb, and even at these extreme settings, it doesn't get swampy or unmusical. Now, the way we currently have this rigged up is so that the output from channel B is going to both sides of the reverb, which is coming out of both XLRs, output A and output B, over here. And we've done that using a simple jumper cable in the back. Now, what you can do with this is you can send two sources to channel A and to channel B and have them both emerge from separate outputs. So if you wanted to, you could use this to cleanly amplify, say, a vocal microphone or a second instrument, and you could use channel A to warm up an acoustic guitar if that was the sort of thing you'd be interested in doing. Or perhaps if you're just playing with another acoustic bandmate, you can amplify both of your guitars through this single pedal, which is very, very cool. I think it's probably a rather preamp rather than a pedal because there's no foot switch, so there you go. I will just knock that back onto mute though, because what we're gonna do next is we're gonna explore channel A, which has this rather interesting heat control, which is gonna be a valve stage that will introduce some subtle compression and harmonic saturation. And as we turn that heat up, it's gonna get more and more overdriven. Not to the point of insanity, but you'll get the picture. So let's switch that over now. All right, so now we're all set up for stereo operation going into channel A. We're gonna exploit the valve stage with this one and get, like I say, a little bit of subtle compression and saturation going on. Let's knock it off mute. I'm doing it with this rather sturdy little toggle switch here, but you can use a foot switch for the same function. Of course, the LED tells you whether you're on mute or play. Pretty cool. Let's hear how it sounds with the heat control on its minimum. It's gonna sound like this. So with this channel, even with the heat control turned all the way down, we are getting a little bit of subtle valve breakup and some upper harmonics that are really quite pleasing. There's a little bit of a crackle in the sound, if you even want to call it that, but that's just the valve breaking up in a nice musical kind of way. What I'm going to do next is turn the heat control up and we'll see where that gets us. So even with the heat control only halfway up, we're really starting to get some lovely valve purr and kind of saturation around the sound. It's a beautiful noise, but it doesn't feel out of control, even though we're playing fairly loudly through our stage monitors. Now, this is where these controls up here are going to come in kind of useful, because we have independent phase reverse switches for both channels. You haven't got one big master thing. If, for example, you had one guitar plugged through this that was interacting badly with your monitors, and the other one was behaving quite well, you could flip the phase on one channel and not the other, which sounds really rather cool. There are also independent ground lifts for the same reason. Now, one other little setting I'm gonna try is with the heat control all the way up, and we'll see where that gets us. Thank you. So with the heat control turned this high, things are really starting to get beyond the realms of clean acoustic guitar reproduction and into downright filth. But because we're using a valve to generate said filth, it is super responsive to your touch. So if you dig in hard, you get a real purr and warmth around the sound. But if you play very, very gently, things do clean up quite nicely, which is very cool indeed. Now, one last experiment I want to try with this one. I'm going to knock it back onto mute. We're going to switch over to a bass guitar, and I'm going to see how this heat control does at warming up a bass signal. All right, so we switched to this beautiful Elric bass guitar. I know it says acoustic preamp, but it just screams bass to me. So we've set all the EQ to the center detent. Everything is flat. The heat control is on zero, and we're going to turn that up as we play. Let's hear how it sounds. And we'll turn it all the way up, see what it does. So of course you're going to have to excuse my distinctly substandard bass playing. I am a guitar player after all. But I think you'll agree that the heat control on the Orange Acoustic preamp does a great job warming up sources that aren't just acoustic guitars. So while it is primarily intended for acoustic guitars, you may think about using it on all sorts of different stuff. Thought it did a great job on this bass guitar, even though, like I say, the input was less than stellar. But hey, you can blame me for that. Anyway guys, I'm going to leave that there. That is the Acoustic preamp from Orange. I've had a great time playing with this one. I think it's a really useful and fantastic sounding device. But for the time being, I shall bid you adieu. My name is Nick Jennison for Guitar Interactive Magazine. I'll see you next time.